These are my boobs. My ex-boobs. But still my boobs.
If you had to describe your boobs, what words would you use?
First and foremost, resilient. They have been through a lot. I feel for them. Oddly shaped. Playful. They are a little bit jiggly and inviting. Truth. This one time I went to my mom's friend's house and they were like super bougie people and they just got a kitten. And I was like so excited to go hold this kitten. And the kitten reached into my bra and pulled out the tissue paper from my bra in front of everybody. And I literally, like, my soul has left the chat. This demon cat just outed me in front of everybody. What the hell? You know, the time I was like 12, 13 years old, it's when you kind of look at your girlfriends and their boobies are coming in and you're just like, okay, oh my God, I'm like excited for mine to come in. And then they just never did. I just didn't know what to do because you can't just produce boobs out of nothing. Tissue paper, socks, double padded bras. When I discovered that, my whole closet was just full of these like triple padded fucking bras that I was just like layered in, and I would just shove my boob up and shove it up, and then sometimes I would add even more padding in there and I was just like, look at me. Let me get into character. These are my boobies. This is all I got. These are my boobies. This is one life I got. That's all I got. That's it. Since the tissue was pulled out of my bra, I've been chasing that idea of womanhood. And fast forward, I went through a lot of traumatic stuff in my own life, and I just lost my father. I think psychologically, I just wanted to regain control over my life. And at the time, it really was empowering for me to be like, I finally am getting the thing that I've wanted my whole life. I had implants back in 2016, and then immediately, like, I started getting really sick and like mentally sick as well. The anxiety started really bad. I was getting heart palpitations, my skin went gray, my eyes went black, my hair started getting really dry and breaking apart. And my world just went from this to this, like really, really quickly. And I had no idea what was going on. I went to, I would say, a dozen different doctors. Everyone around me was making me feel like, I think it's in your head. I think this is not really a thing that's happening. I think, you know, try some antidepressants or something. Suddenly I just came across this Instagram post by this woman. I saw that she had just got her breast implants out, and I saw like the changes in her face and all these symptoms that she was describing. I was like, that's me, that's me. And I don't even remember what that tipping point was. I think it was just overwhelming looking at other women's stories. Holy shit. I'm getting an explant. Like, I had built myself this exterior of perfection. I was this model and I was constantly everywhere and doing photo shoots, and I was this like hypersexual person. And to give all that up, it was really unbelievably painful. And I remember dropping it very casually to my boyfriend, like, what are you gonna do when I get an explant and I don't look this way anymore? He was just like, I will always love you, no matter what. I thought I wanted this my whole life. And here they are. I was really like heavy into body modification and tattoos, as you can see, and I was doing all this external stuff to try and make myself feel better. I just got to a point where I was like, I need to reclaim my life, just be myself. Like, I fucking paid a lot of money for these. I'm gonna keep them, goddammit. I went through anger and grief. It was an actual mourning process of my body, reclaiming my sexuality and my, you know, comfort with my boyfriend, and not even just with my boyfriend, but being able to look at myself in the mirror. The color in my eyes came back. I had red cheeks again. My heart palpitations stopped, and I felt happy for the first time in so long. For me, this is all about informed consent, because I'm never gonna tell any woman or any person what to do or not to do this or don't do this. We don't really understand the depth of what's really going on with these implants and what it actually does to our body. The FDA put it on their website that breast implant illness is a real thing. So it was really validating for a lot of women. Society tries to make women a trend. So sometimes big butts and thighs are in, and sometimes you have to be real thin, and sometimes you have to have little boobs, and sometimes you have to have big boobs. Women are constantly chasing this elusive version of womanhood, and like, we can't ever keep up. We're saying fuck this, we're saying stop photoshopping us, we want to see cellulite, we want to see natural bodies. Society really needs to start catching up, because we cannot keep chasing something that does not exist. I love that I look in the mirror now and I see these scars that are huge and they are bigger than my boobs are. I think they're the most beautiful little things ever. I love them, because I'm weird too. Loving yourself for the real, messy, real, natural part of yourself is the most difficult thing. But if you can push through that and really just look at yourself and be like, I fucking love you. Look at you. You are a bad bitch. That is how I feel now. I just feel like, holy shit, I'm a bad bitch. All right. Hi, my name is Laura Hesp. I'm the founder of Inclusive Love. These are my boobs, and this is their truth.